Hello, Katie. Amazing to have you in the chat. Hello, hello. So guys, for all you watching, Katie is in the beauty industry. She's a business mentor. And may I ask you to introduce yourself?
My name is Katie Godfrey, and yeah, I'm the owner of the KG brand. So that consists of a beauty salon, that consists of a product training and training academy, and business mentoring. So we do various things, but it's mainly all within the hair and beauty space.
Amazing. So let's dive in. Let's go back to history.
So from Bedfordshire in the UK, so I don't know if you've heard of that, a small little town there, and my upbringing was amazing. Like, my parents were incredible. School was a very difficult subject, so I actually left school at 13 years old due to bullying. So I left school for like no qualifications whatsoever. And I was modelling, and modelling actually like saved my life, because it got me out the house, it got me networking, and actually taught me how to like run a business as well, because I was self-employed from such a young age. That fast forward led on to me opening a beauty salon, which was really like off the cuff, and like, it was never my dream to open up a beauty salon, but I always wanted a tanning shop. So I thought, well, let's open a tanning shop, and I combined it with the modelling and stuff like that, and it just grew and turned into this full blown salon over time. And it was hard, don't get me wrong, we had many, many challenges. I opened up the salon with no clientele whatsoever. Wow. I didn't know what I was doing. I was 19, so I was extremely young, and I just had to learn on the job, basically. I had to learn how to run teams. I had to learn how to build a business. I had to learn how to get a clientele and build a brand. And I just studied business inside out, so I would be as successful as I could. And the salon grew over time, and that led on to then starting the other companies. And yeah, everything's just absolutely amazing, but it wasn't what I visioned. This isn't ever what I thought that I would do, but I wouldn't change it for the world.
Now there's two questions. You never thought that you're going to be in this business. So what was your, as a girl, what did you think or dream of being?
As a really young girl, I just wanted to be a vet. until I realized all the things that aren't so nice and cuddly, I was like, okay, I don't want to do that. But then as when I was modeling, all I wanted to do was continue modeling. I couldn't see myself doing anything else at all. There was no other aspirations or goals to hit. I just wanted to be really successful in modeling. So the career change really, really changed direction. And now I can't imagine doing anything else.
How time changes also the wishes and where you're in then and where you're at. So you were talking about bullying. So that was a huge challenge. And you also left school at 13. So that must have been a pretty tough time for you. How did it stand? How did you cope with all that trouble?
I say I didn't cope really. I was very close to wanting to end my life. I tried self-harming. It was a very, very, very difficult time. And I was so young. So anything anyone said to me, I really believed and took on board. It's not like now when you're a bit more wise and can, you know, separate things. So it was a really, really difficult time. The people that kept me going was my parents. So my mum and dad were extremely supportive, and it wasn't until they pulled me out of school that then I started to be okay again. But I was literally like a recluse in my house. Like, I was so scared to surround myself with women or girls at the time, because I thought they'd all be the same. It took a lot of healing, a lot of therapy, and a lot of self inner work really, to be able to be the person I am today.
It's beautiful that you talk about that, because a lot of people, we all had somewhere, you know, a major issue when it comes down to bullying or discrimination or whatever. So that's really good that and amazing that you talk about that. So you were also mentioning therapy, coaching therapy. So how did that help you, and how did you find the right help for you? Because that's also a topic. How do you find the right help then?
I'm a very massive advocate when it comes to therapy. I think it's very important. I think even if tragic things haven't happened in your life, therapy is always really good if you can go to a therapist regularly and just offload life. So I would always recommend therapy anyway, but I guess just finding that person for you, that person that you can connect with, a person that you can be really open with, is really, really important. And it's so clever because even if there's things that you're going through currently and you're struggling with, more than likely when they talk to you and take you back, everything always stems from your childhood. So it's always really interesting just to kind of figure out the pieces and heal from stuff in your childhood that you might not even realise was there.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really good, and I literally highly recommend therapy to everyone, even if you don't feel that there's something that you need to massively get over, just to talk to someone and offload.
I like that, Katie. Even if you don't think you're always going to have something rare to improve on or to work on, and even if you don't know, because that's the blind spot, then right?
Exactly.
Yeah, beautifully said, Katie. So now let's go back. So, and I also love that story, you know, because if you grow out of something which was really tough, and then something beautiful as this happens, you know, with the modeling. So you were very successful in the modeling space. Then you, how did the idea came of opening a shop? What was it, kind of a thought or a vision you had? Or was it just kind of coincidence?
So I always wanted to open up a tanning shop, but I also had a model agency at the same time. So when I was 18, I started a model agency. Because I was in the modeling space for so long, lots of agents would come to me and say, do you know a model for this job? Do you know a model for that job? And I could always fulfill it. So I thought, well, I'm going to start doing this business myself. So I worked from home and my parents' home in their office, running the model agency. And I always wanted a base for it, like an office to meet my models, to do photographic work, to measure them, etc. But I also wanted a tanning shop. So I found this location, which is obviously my salon now, and we combined the two together. So you'd walk in and it'd be the tanning shop, and then you'd walk through again and it'd be the model agency and the photographic studio. But as we grew and people wanted more services, I had to make that decision of this building needs to be used as a full-blown beauty salon. So we had to close the model agency down to grow in the other business. And back then, thinking about it, I thought I was failing because I was closing a business, but it was actually opening a massive door to something else that was going to be happening, which I had no idea about, which is obviously everything I've created today.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's led me to where I am today, definitely.
That's amazing. And you were very young, you know, like, how did you, who was supporting you when it comes down to insurance, finances and so on? Because that's a huge one as well.
So, honestly, I look at people now that are that age, 18, 19, and I think, how the hell did I do that? Like, I don't know. I think there was a couple of battles going on in my head. I've always been quite driven. I've always, you know, wanted a lifestyle and nice things. And my parents have always worked, so I always had that work ethic. And I think because I left school with nothing, I had the option to either carry on doing nothing or go into a job that wasn't going to fulfill me. Just because I had no qualifications, didn't have much options, or I had to create something of myself. So because I was so young, I could take a bigger risk financially because I didn't have a mortgage, I didn't have children at the time. So I got loans out, and the banks would not do this nowadays, but I was up to my eyes in debt to set the shop up, to do my training courses. And it was either you make it or you become bankrupt. There's your two options, and they're your only two options. So I give myself a 5-year goal to make sure that I could pay off the debt and be debt free in 5 years, and I done it. So.
Oh my God, I love that, Katie. Because it also shows, like, it was kind of, when I like listen to you, it kind of sometimes sounds like, that was also survival mode. Either you make it or, like, you know, was that kind of that feeling and that pressure you needed to, you know, push yourself forward?
Oh my gosh, yeah, like it was literally fight or flight. Like, and I'd fight, but there was a few times I wanted to flight. And there was times where I would call my mum in particular and be like, I can't do it anymore, mum. I'm just going to go bankrupt, like, and just go and get a job somewhere. Like, this is so much stress. And obviously I was so young and my friends were out partying and doing stuff that we would do at that age. And I'm slaving away trying to, like, do business, get clients in, learn, like, all of that. It was literally survival mode. Mm-hmm. But even though there was times I wanted to chuck in the towel and go bankrupt, I just couldn't do that. I had to keep going.
Keep going. Oh my God, I love it. I love it. And now today, so you had a struggle, but you made it and you gave yourself 5 years. I love that. Also a time and a goal. I love that. And you made it. So you can be so proud of yourself. I mean, wow. Where do you support others?
So from obviously doing that business, I learned how to run teams. I learned leadership. I learned how to build a brand from literally scratch. And the biggest turning point was I had my little girl, and I had my little girl, she's nearly 7 now, but I was a single mum at 10 weeks pregnant. So I'd done the whole pregnancy alone. I'd done the upbringing on my own, but I was running these businesses. So what I'd done in that time I was pregnant was managed to learn the businesses without me physically being in them and having teams in them. So then I could still have time with my little girl, but also be at home building the businesses without me being physically there. So from that story and that success that I've made from that, I now help other women in business. Not that just have children, but that have children that want to start families, that just want some freedom in their business, to learn to delegate, build teams, and to not be so connected to their business that they can learn to grow. And I'm pretty good at that when it comes to helping the other business women, and that's where my passion is. Like, I love creating that freedom for people, but you also have to be willing to let go to be able to build the business to that level. So that's what I do, like, mainly day in, day out. The salon's still there. It runs completely on its own. I'm very, very rarely there unless I'm getting treatment myself. I've got my training academies, and we have academies all over the country, and I have incredible trainers that run them. We've got our product range that obviously we distribute worldwide. So that's eyelash products and brow products to professionals. And obviously the business mentoring and podcasting, which I do most of the time myself. I've just been able to create this business that's around my family. Like, I'm expecting another baby now, and it's, like, so amazing because I've already created that freedom and that flexibility within the business to be able to have another baby and not have to worry. So it's really good. And I just love being able to help people do exactly what I've done and let them fast forward all the years that I had to struggle.
And wow, you can be so proud of yourself. I mean, at this young age, and also the understanding of learning to let go of your business, that's a huge one. Actually, I'm also working on myself in that topic, because it's really important that you're able to let go and then trust that it's going to work out, that you can focus on the next ones or on projects, you know. That's so right. That's true.
We love our businesses so much, right? Like, we love our businesses, we think they're our babies, like, we put everything into them, and of course you love your businesses, you've got to love what you do, but when you're so emotionally connected, it's so hard to, like, let go and grow or let other people take over. I still love all of my companies, but there's definitely, it's just my companies now, and then it's separated with family.
Yeah.
So it does make it easier.
Yeah, that's such a great piece of advice for all the listeners out there. That's something, actually, I didn't expect in the chat, but it's amazing. I love things that pop up, you know, whereas I'm like, that's a huge one. That's a huge takeaway for people who are watching this. And so that's beautiful. So Katie, I got some questions, short questions then. So, so your main coaching topic as business mentor?
My main coaching topic is building teams. Mm-hmm.
Then your techniques and tools you use for your clients?
For my coaching clients?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So one-to-one sessions to get them motivated. We could do group sessions. We do a lot of mindset work because it starts within before producing outweighs, and just getting them to believe in themselves and that they can do it, and being really focused. And we do a lot of goal planning as well. Where would you like to be? And then working backwards, and then that helps people progress.
Beautiful. Done. Your biggest strength in one word?
My biggest strength? Passion.
Beautiful. The goal you aim for your customers, 3 words.
To be successful.
Amazing. I love that. I always like listening, and it's so, and it also fits when people talking about themselves, and then you have these damn questions, and it fits so, it's so resonating, so beautifully answered, Katie. So, Katie, I mean, you are doing amazing. So you're expecting now your second child, right? Your second baby?
Okay. Yeah, my second.
Yeah, and you're so successful. You know, that's also for the listeners out there. You can make it no matter how your age, because even if it's very young, I mean, that's very impressive. Or even, there's one coach I know, she's like 73 or whatever. So it's beautiful to see that if you're following your passion, also kind of in a survival mode, I like that as well, but if you follow your passion, you can definitely make it. And that's so beautiful. So what is your... Have you got a vision, a long-term vision for yourself, where you say like, oh, that's my 5-year vision or 10 vision or a bigger vision?
Obviously, to be more successful than I am currently, mm-hmm. I really want to build up the coaching side of the business and the podcast, because that's the newest part of the company. So I've been doing that about 3 years now. Mm-hmm. But the podcasting is definitely where I want to grow, because we give away so much free advice. We interview people like this, and it just helps people that aren't ready for a coach yet, or aren't ready to invest yet, or just starting out, really just to motivate them and give them that head start. So I guess being able to connect with more people in business, any business, doesn't have to be beauty, doesn't have to be hair, it doesn't have to be women, like it can be female or male, just starting out and giving them a boost to keep going.
Amazing. So where can people listen to your podcast and find you?
Any podcast station, and it's called The Life of KG.
Mm-hmm. Amazing. And you're an inspiration for many people out there. And one can see, I mean, you're still very young, but you're so mature. That's my impression of you. You know, you've done a lot. You can be proud of yourself.
Sometimes you do think, wow, I can't believe I've done all of that. Mm-hmm. So interviewing and stuff really, really helps that, just to look back and see everything you've done. Because life's so busy, right? You just get caught in the moment and you just carry on with life, and you kind of forget what you've done. So it is really important to always look back and share your story. And yeah,
that's true, but you can be really, really proud of yourself. And one piece of advice I forgot that one piece of advice for a young person struggling, not knowing what to do.
Find what your passion is, because you can't do something for money, you have to do it for passion, and just keep working and studying on that to keep going. And don't be the 94% of people that chuck in the towel so easy. Be that 3% that carry on, because it's worth it, but you have to put the grind in for it to work out and be successful.
Amazing piece of advice. So it was a wonderful chat with you. Thank you so much for being part of this and for you helping others, supporting others, and doing what you do. It's great. It's amazing. Bye bye, Didi. Bye bye. And thank you so much.
Bye bye. Take care. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye bye, Didi.